Okay, let's try this again. The 50 most disturbing films of all time, as compiled by somebody that doesn't know what disturbing means, I guess. Anywho, I did this in 2013 for my blog. I watched all 50 of these movies and rated them for how disturbing I thought they were from a scale of 1 to 10. I have no hope of saying the first one A, with a little thing on top of it. Hyphen INTERIEUR. I have no idea how to pronounce this. It's not even close to English, and I don't even know what language it is. From 2007. 5 out of 10. A Serbian film, uncut. This is from 2010. That was a 10 out of 10 because there was a scene with a child in it that really freaked my shit out, and I didn't like it at all. Happiness, 1998, 1 out of 10. I don't know how this got to be even on the list. Snowtown, 2011, 2 out of 10. August Underground's Mortem, 2003, 6 out of 10. Guinea Pig, The Devil's Experiment, 1995. There's an urban legend about this film being real, but it's not because there's a making of. In fact, a star that I can't remember the name of thought it was real to the point that he turned it into the police. And the police thought it was real. So, anyways, 3 out of 10. It really wasn't that good. And I don't know how anyone thought this was a real movie or a real snuff film. So I really don't know. Man Bites Dog, 1992, 4 out of 10. And Necromantic, 1987, 6 out of 10. Eden Lake, which I recently rewatched, 2008, 3 out of 10. Now, as a movie, I rated that on IMDb a 7 out of 10, by the way. As disturbing, it's only gonna give you a 3. The Last House on the Left, 1972, 5 out of 10. Audition, 2001, 5 out of 10. Dogtooth, 2009, 4 out of 10. I Spit on Your Grave, 1978, 5 out of 10. And LOL as a note. So, yeah. By the way, the remake of I Spit on Your Grave is not even worth watching. The Right, 2011, 3 out of 10. Threads, 1984, 6 out of 10. Aftermath, 1994, 5 out of 10. Cannibal Holocaust, 1980, 9 out of 10. Funny Games, 1997, 3 out of 10. Irreversible, not spelt normally, 2002, 4 out of 10. Martyrs, 2008, 5 out of 10. The remake, which is 2018, I do believe, or something like that, is would be a 1 out of 10 for the gruesome level. Pink Flamingos, 1972, 1 out of 10. This is not a very disturbing movie at all. Why this was even in the list, I don't know, but it's a hilarious movie. It's a very much an art film, but it's a hilarious movie if you're on the right kind of drugs, I guess. Taxidermia, 2006, 4 out of 10. The Bunny Gang, 2010, 3 out of 10. Now, there is a few viral images that came out of the Bunny Gang that are supposedly urban lore now. So, yeah, anyways. Visitor Q, 2001. 2 out of 10. I don't know why I got two ratings for this. There's two ratings. One of them is a different. I don't know. Whatever. A Clockwork Orange, 1971, 1 out of 10, but it's a damn good movie, but it's just not that disturbing. The book, on the other hand, the UK version of the book, that is, I would say is an incredibly good book and way more disturbing. Eraserhead, 1977, 1 out of 10, but yeah, it's a bizarre movie. Habeas Corpus, 2012, 6 out of 10. Henry, Portrait of a Serial Killer, 1986, 4 out of 10. Inside, 2007, 5 out of 10. Me Behind the Sun, or Men Behind the Sun, 1988, 2 out of 10. No, another one I don't know how it even got on the list. Solo, or A 120 Days of Sodom, 1975, 7 out of 10. This is a very hard to watch movie though, because it's dull, although it was quite disturbing. Teeth, 2007, 8 out of 10. Begotten, 1990, 8 out of 10. Cutting Moments, 1997, 7 out of 10. Frontier, Frontier with a S in brackets. 2007, that is, 5 out of 10. Guinea Pig, the Followers of Flesh and Blood, 1985, 7 out of 10. Inbred, 2012, five out of 10. Philosophy of a Knife, 2008, 4 out of 10. Requiem for a Dream, 2000. How is this even disturbing? Yes, is the comment on that one. The Green Elephant, 1999, 9 out of 10. Antichrist, 2009, 4 out of 10, although it gets a bonus point for breaking the guy's balls. Anyways, Cannibal, 2006, 3 out of 10. The note I put behind that was yawn. Slaughterhouse Vomit Dolls. Now, one of my friends commented on this one about that, with just that title, because it's so absurd. 2006, 5 out of 10. The Whoever Tapes, Puffakisses Tapes, Puffakiss. I don't know if I'm saying that right or not. 7 out of 10. The Human Centipede, First Sequence, 2009, 10 out of 10. The Human Centipede 2, Full Sequence, 2011, 10 out of 10. Grotesque, 2009, 8 out of 10. And if I remember, that was an appropriate title. Faces of Death, 1978. I have never seen a movie this fake in my life. It's supposed to be real deaths actually on film, and it is bizarrely bad. I mean, it's 2 out of 10, by the way. How anyone thought this was real, I don't know. I just don't. Megan is Missing, 2011, 4 out of 10. Yeah. The Girl Next Door, 2007, 3 out of 10, and that's them. Have a good one.